backlog was too big, and Congress was on their heads to move the cases fast.
Now to a follow-up on our Waste Watch report. Who's to blame for the massive problem sinking Social Security disability?
We've reported the Social Security Trust Fund is quickly running out of money. The program could actually be bankrupt in less than 2 years, meaning millions will see their benefits cut.
As part of our ongoing investigation, we're now getting more insight into who may actually be at fault here.
Yeah, CBS 21's Chris Papps joins us now with the latest in his exclusive investigation. So far, some jaw-dropping stuff this week from you, Chris. No. What do you have tonight?
All right, well, Rob and Tanya, as you know, back in May, we first started reporting on the problems with the Social Security disability system, and Judge Charles Bridges, a Harrisburg disability judge who has awarded billions of tax dollars in disability benefits, by far the most of any judge in the nation. But now, two current disability judges have come forward after seeing our story to say the problem isn't so much with the judges, but rather the federal government.
Bureaucrats in Social Security have a long and sordid history of mismanaging this program.
So you're saying your bosses are mismanaging the system?
Yes.
For Marilyn Zahm, the problem facing Social Security disability is simple.
The system lacks integrity.
Zahm is a disability judge in Buffalo, New York, and the vice president of the Association of Disability Judges. She watched back in May as CBS 21 aired a story dealing with Harrisburg disability judge Charles Bridges. Since 2005, according to the Social Security Administration, Judge Bridges has personally awarded $4.6 billion in disability benefits to more than 15,000 people, by far the most of any judge in the country. At 90%, the judge's grant rate is more than twice the national average.
The truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
After our story aired, Judge Bridges was subpoenaed to testify before Congress in Washington, D.C. While under oath, he refuted CBS 21's reporting, calling our numbers factually inaccurate and not verifiable, even though we got the numbers from the Social Security Administration. The judge defended his work by saying this.
This Harrisburg CBS affiliate reported a figure of $4.6 billion of taxpayers' money. How erroneous a statement was that? I have been a highly productive judge in the Social Security Administration because of my motivation and work ethic.
But either way, Zahm says judges like Bridges are not entirely to blame.
It wasn't the judges who were out of control, it was the managers who were out of control.
Zahm says the problem started in 2007, when an aging population combined with the recession created a spike in disability claims. By 2008, waiting lists of up to 2 years had formed in many parts of the country. And the way the federal government dealt with the backlogs, according to Zahm, bankrupted the system.
Judges were encouraged and promoted to pay everything and just move cases and move a lot of cases. No one will complain because the cases don't get appealed.
Were you personally encouraged to push these cases through?
Yes.
Now, 11 years later, 11 million Americans receive disability, a 45% increase in the last decade, costing taxpayers $128 billion annually. The trust fund is now scheduled to run out of money in 2 years, and Washington has a crisis on its hands.
The agency knew this was going on, in fact, wanted it to go on, knowing full well that all sorts of people were being paid inappropriately. Nobody cared.
It's a program.
Randy Fry is a disability judge in North Carolina and the president of the association.
That's essentially run by bureaucrats in Baltimore who have no experience in handling disability cases.
Fry agrees federal policies of 5 years ago sank the program, but he feels current policy is now keeping it down. He says disability judges have had their hands tied. For example, they used to be able to use mental tests or social media to rule on a case, but they no longer can.
We were using it, and it was beneficial.
Fry also believes disability hearings should be open to the public and the media. Right now, they're not.
When you're being watched, you're going to do better.
But the biggest issue, he says, is that there's no one in the courtroom representing the taxpayer.
80% of all claimants come to our hearings with an attorney. 80%. And the government has no one to represent their interests. Thus, the American people have no one that represents their interests.
CBS 21 did reach out to the Social Security Administration and received this response. Quote, hearings are closed in order to protect the privacy of the individual and the sensitive medical information that may be shared. The use of social media to investigate claimants could improperly disclose a claimant's personal information, expose our internal systems to greater risk of infiltration, and raise due process concerns. The agency plan to eliminate the hearings backlog required both timely and policy-compliant decisions. We make it clear that agency adjudicators may not disregard requirements simply to, quote, pay down the backlog or rubber stamp benefits.
If there isn't some kind of a positive change now, I'm afraid that we've missed the opportunity forever.
We need not throw away the whole system simply because we're too lazy or ineffectual to deal with some of the flaws.
Now, another concern the judges have is that they believe there's no current leadership coming from the federal government. A year and a half ago, the commissioner for the Social Security Administration resigned, and President Obama has not found a permanent replacement. Live in the studio, Chris Pabst, CBS 21 News.